Get me ready, oh, oh, oh. Taking you down, city streets. you hear the thump of bass. Going to the underground place where we all come together. UK to New York. Bringing the underground sounds to all the people of the world.
my house. No one came to my house. No one came to my house with $1 million. No one came to my house with $1 million in their hand either. Still got all my records collection. And I'm just a big fan of the whole situation. And I still live in Detroit. You know, can't wait to die. My story is the same old story. Watching black exploitation movie or any, you know, the whole situation. One parent turned into no parent, just being out there with friends and starting to get involved with music at an early age. And, you know, you start getting a little group together, and you get signed to somebody that's probably lived around the corner from you, and all that worked out. But one thing you get to know is the business side after all of that. You know, yeah, as children we was mad, we didn't get no money, we didn't get this. But you know, what people do forget is there is another classroom besides the one in high school that's out here. And that was probably the best education I had. I was never under the pressure of doing so many albums, you know. I just enjoyed it. It was fun. I never thought it would take me certain places. It was just enjoyable to do. Idea was to send your white label test pressing to the distributor, and the distributor would then call you and let you know, or fax you and let you know how many you're receiving or how many they want. Well, today, as I did in the 90s and the late 80s, it's still the same structure. I will send you that white label, but I'll explain to you how many you are receiving. You know, and that was either you take it or leave it. You know, when I first started this, you know, you get you a couple of dollars. You know, you rack up a few dollars, you're about to press it, and everybody comes to you and say, well, you need a lawyer, you need a A&R, you need a manager, you need an accountant, you need this. You know, I'm sitting here with $100 trying to figure out, well, what about pressing the records? Okay, yeah, we'll get to that. You know, so, but one thing no one ever told me, which I have to say, I had to sit down and think about myself. What about a motherfucker you could trust? Because see, a motherfucker you could trust can learn all of that. And eventually, phone calls were coming. All you got to do is answer the phone. And to this day, I'm going to tell you something. You know, and there's a couple of other young ladies that helped me out. You know, I have a few as if I got to get up and do something, that means somebody ain't doing their job. See, I was never under the pressure of doing so many albums, you know. I just enjoyed it. It was fun. I never thought it would take me certain places. It was just enjoyable to do. pretty seat by my bed. You understand? I've told you before, that's my wife, that's my woman. I just throw my ideas on there. I get to the studio later. That makes it fun for me.
this feeling. I just can't stop this feeling. I just can't stop this feeling. Daily motivation, the sweetest sensation. Ooh, you got me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.